So this is what we are discussing in the last class, right? So with this example, we'll try to close the first chapter. So let's look at what is being asked. So upper and lower heating values. I believe now everyone is clear. What is the difference between upper and lower heating values? Can anyone tell me?
The state of water obtained.
Correct. So water is the product. So your product is at liquid state or at vapor state, that will determine whether it is an upper or lower heating value. Okay. So the question asks that you find these values at 298 K, it means nearly at the room temperature, for gaseous decay per kilomole and per kilogram. So basically the same quantity you have to express in different units. Molecular weight is given. Fine. Then there's a B part which says that now we are talking about phase change of water only. Water is liquid or vapor here. We're also considering the phase change of decay. Okay, so if you consider for any liquid fuel, for example, petrol, diesel, kerosene, or decay, you also need to evaporate that fuel. Okay, the gaseous, the reaction, combustion reactions that we'll be talking about in the next few chapters, that take place in gaseous phase. So if you have liquid, first you have to, that's why we do, we try to form spray, we try to make smaller droplets which will evaporate fast, and then all the reactions take place in vapor form. So that also is to be considered for this question, that how much energy we need to supply, okay, to decay, to evaporate. That's all being asked in this part of the question. Okay, so let us start with the first part. So for any such question, what is the first step is, you first write a balanced equation. Okay, how many moles of oxygen and nitrogen are involved reacting with a given one mole of fuel. Okay, let us start with gaseous decay. So when I write balanced equation, I know how much, what are the coefficients in the RHS and LHS. Okay. Now, for both lower and upper heating values, heat of combustion or heat of reaction will be same. It will be the enthalpy difference between reactant and products. Okay, only for upper and lower, we need to also incorporate latent heat. Otherwise, all the other things will be same. So that's what is written here. So liquid form or gaseous form. So basically these are standard species at reference temperature, oxygen, nitrogen. So that will have zero enthalpy. So we'll again follow the same procedure. We'll calculate the enthalpy of reactant by taking summation of all the species. Similarly for product, we'll take sum over all the species in the product side and get the sum, get a final H product. So for, let us start with higher heating value where water becomes liquid. So heat of combustion for, this is how you will write, heat of combustion for water, assuming water is liquid, we have this. So we are talking about decay. We'll talk about the energy formation of decay and CO2 and H2O. Okay, these two we are not taking because there's no, okay, another interesting thing is that the question asks about heating values at 298 K, which is a standard reference temperature. Okay, so here, first of all, this will go to zero. There's no energy required in formation, naturally occurring species. Now, another interesting thing is that there will be no sensible enthalpy. I don't need to heat. So basically what happens is that you have reactant at reference temperature, you burn it and then they go to higher temperature, right? Now the question asks that what is the heating values at this temperature only? So sensible heat is not involved in this calculation. So can anyone explain what is going on? How can I talk about 298K when I'm burning something? It will go to very high temperatures, right? So why, how come I'm talking about 298, or what is the theoretical assumption involved? on what basis I can take 298 for a combustion product? Anyone guess?
Sir, maybe assumption is that the temperature of the whole system is not changing, so we can use in that way.
You are going in the right direction, but the temperature will change, right?
Yes, sir, will there burn. Will be some change.
So, okay, I will explain. So basically, theoretically, you can imagine that it is burning, right? But I extract that heat. I use that heat to, let us say, evaporate boiled water or something like that. So theoretically, see, basically what we are doing here, we are taking molecular bond energies and all that. So in that calculation, I can assume that at the end of the reaction or end of the process, the product is also brought back to this temperature, brought back by taking out heat or any other thing. Mostly that heat will be used to heat some other gas or some other liquid. Okay, the most general thing to do is use it to boil water. Okay, you can use water in some power plant or something like that. So theoretically, what we think of is that, okay, we are taking it back to that temperature, and then by doing that, we will not talk about sensible heat because the product are also at the same temperature. So it is just a calculation, right? So in calculations, you can assume some things, you can add some terms, remove some terms with some basis, not arbitrarily. So our basis here is that assuming that heat is being extracted from the products in such a way that they are coming back to this temperature. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes. Sir.
Okay. So now coming back to this equation. So this is the standard equation to find enthalpy of heat of combustion, higher heating value. So we'll talk about reactant, H reactant minus H product. So this is your H reactant. Why one is here? Because 1 mole of this gas is here, 10 moles of CO2, okay, 11 moles of water. So just multiply 10 by heat of formation of CO2 and heat of formation of water. Okay, now heat of formation of liquid water will be equal to heat of formation of gaseous or vapor, and the difference will be your latent heat, right? So generally in tables, these two quantities are available. If you have this, then you can directly use this value. If you don't have the heat of formation for liquid, then you can simply take heat of formation for gaseous and subtract latent heat. Okay, so finally we obtain this, which is 285 minus 285. 857 kilojoule per kilomole. So, okay. Now, okay, one animation is not working properly. Now we are going again back to the same equation. In this equation, not what we have. This is generally available. This is available in table, or it will either, you can look up the table. I will show you maybe after some time. Or this quantity will be given in the question. So you can take directly from there. You can take from, for CO2 you can take. Water we have just calculated here. So if you substitute all these values in this equation, so this is what we'll get. Okay. This is for decane. This is for CO2. And 11 is for water. So you have to multiply and add. Add, subtract, so this is what you will get. Now, one thing is missing from here. I should write it like, can you tell me how, no, it is not missing actually, we have multiplied. So this is for kilojoule. If I talk about one mole of that reactant, so I'll have, this will be in kilojoule per kilomole, okay. If 1 kilomole of the reactant, if I take 1 kilomole of the decane, so I can write this quantity 1 kilojoule per kilomole. And the question says that you find it in kilojoule per kilomole and kilojoule per kilogram. So from this given quantity, can I find this in kilojoule per kilogram? What we need to do? or what number will come here? Yes. So I have heat of reaction in kilojoule per kilomole. I also want in kilojoule per kilogram. So what one step I have to take?
The molar mass of C NH2.
So I will divide it by molar mass and I will get this value in kilojoule per kilogram. That is the first part of your question. Any doubt here or clear? Okay.
Clear, sir.
Let us go to the second part. So second part, let us look at what it was asking. So second part ask if the enthalpy of decay is given. Okay, now we are also considering how to evaporate the fuel. So then you find same things, upper and lower heating values. Only difference will be that you also consider this. Okay, so for lower heating value, we use heat of formation for gaseous, and for higher heating values, we use heat of formation for liquid. We just now found in the last slide. Okay, now my animation is not working properly, but anyway. Now what we do here is, let me get a pointer. Okay. So for higher heating value, again, same procedure will follow. Only we need to consider that. Sorry. This is the slide. Wait. So this is what we have. We have found higher heating value. For lower heating value, we'll take for liquid water, we have used this, right? What is the difference between lower and higher heating value? We'll have water in vapor form. So now we'll replace this number by this number. Okay, this is for gaseous. This is for liquid. Okay, if you replace that, then we calculate lower heating value for in kilojoule per kilomole and kilojoule per kilogram. Same procedure. Only this number will be replaced. Okay, this is actually second part of the A question A. Now we'll go to question B. Okay, here we'll talk about the latent heat required for CTNH22. Okay, so liquid fuel, if we are considering liquid fuel, we'll also take enthalpy of gaseous fuel minus latent heat. So same procedure, once you follow, this is what we got in the last part of the question. Now I will just subtract this latent heat for the fuel and I get heat of combustion, higher heating value and lower heating value. Only this is the difference. Let me just mark it. So this is what I got in the last part of the question, part A. Now I'm subtracting this. This is the value considering fuel evaporation. Again, this is what we got in the last part, subtract 359. 359 is coming from here. This is 359. Then we get low rating value. So again, I've just written it just to note it down. So higher rating value, assume all water is in liquid form. Low rating value, vapor form. That's all. So this is how you can graphically see the enthalpy of various stages. Okay, so what you can see here is that product with liquid, it will have lower enthalpy. With water as vapor, it will have higher enthalpy because vapor will have higher energy content as compared to liquid. Similarly, for fuel will have we'll talk about enthalpy of the reactant side. Okay, so if it is liquid, it has lower enthalpy. If it is gas, it has higher enthalpy. So based on that, we take different delta H, what we have seen in last previous slides. So you can go through this once more and see what are the delta H we have taken for part A and B for the last question. Okay, fine. So just one small topic. So we'll talk more about Ottendorf reaction in the next chapter. This was actually in the syllabus, so I'm just discussing it briefly, but I will explain this again when we go to kinetics. So So there are first order reactions which we'll generally talk about. There are also second order reactions which behave like first order. Okay, that reactions we call pseudo order reaction. Okay, this is generally what we are doing is we are taking one material in great excess. Let us say fuel is in large excess or oxygen is in excess. Then, okay, not like that. So let us say A is going from A to B. Some species is getting broken down or decomposing. Then in that case, if it as that is present in large excess, then we say that it is maintained at constant concentration. Okay. Anyway, this we'll explore more about in the next chapter. So this brings us to the end of the first chapter on thermodynamics. So any questions?